Understanding how well hatchery fish do compared to wild fish, scientists are just now beginning to crack that nut. And it may not be the same for each individual species of salmon or steelhead trout. It could be that a species like hatchery steelhead trout may not do as well in the wild as their wild counterpart.
When we talk about gene flow, what we're talking about are characteristics that are favored in a certain environment, and that those traits get passed on from adults to juveniles. The hatchery environment is very protected compared to the natural environment. So when you pass on those traits to the natural population, you're giving them a handicap.
The Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife has a genetics lab that does most of our genetic work for us on these fish. What's good to see is people are doing longer term genetic studies and relative reproductive studies to see if these hatchery fish can reproduce in the wild similar to the wild fish.
We've moved from looking at small pieces of your genetic makeup to your entire genetic makeup, which is referred to as your genome. There's been long discussion about sequencing the human genome. Well, they've done that. And now we're moving towards being able to sequence, understand all of the alphabet of Chinook salmon and steelhead trout. And once we have an understanding about the entire genome, these questions that we're trying to answer about the relationship between hatchery and wild fish and whether we can create a hatchery fish that is as good as a wild fish will be easier to answer once we know the entire genome. And we are just starting to do that now. Understanding the genetics of the hatchery population, understanding the genetics of the wild population allows us to move closer to the point where we can have healthy wild populations at the same time we have healthy hatchery populations that enhance our recreational and commercial fishing and our enjoyment of salmon in the rivers.